God some praise. Amen. Amen. Do me a favor. I want you to praise God for what he has done for you. Amen. And praise God for what you would hope that he would do for you. Amen. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Talk to somebody right now. I've come to realize as I look at the prayer requests and as I pray over, your requests from week to week, you know, one of the things that I'm noticing is that people are at different levels. You know, somebody texted me the other day or DM'd me and was like, E, praise God for what you're doing. I'm not a religious man. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I feel you if what you meant by it was like, you know, you don't really get into all the church stuff. I'm 100%. But if you're saying you're not spiritual, amen, you don't get to make that choice. Hallelujah. You were born. Amen. You're not a creator, so you didn't create yourself, right? So you don't get to decide that you're mind, body, and soul. Like, you don't get to make that decision. Amen. Come on, I'm gonna say it again. You don't get to make that decision. You didn't create yourself. Amen. You were created, and so you are mind, body, and soul, whether you like it or not. And so one of the things that I want to be able to do today, amen, is I want to help you with your spiritual sense. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Common sense ain't common. Amen. Praise God. We have the sense that we have is based on what we were taught in the environment that we grew up in. So I want to give you some spiritual sense. Amen. I want to give you some spiritual sense. So here's what I want you to do. Because you don't necessarily believe there's a God, or maybe you believe, but to a small extent, that's your fault. Amen. I want you to know that the spiritual realm is all around you. Hallelujah. Just because you're not able to acknowledge it doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. Amen. Just because you're not feeling it don't mean that it doesn't exist. So here's what I want you to do for me. I want you to praise the Lord since you have not been able to see the things that have happened around you or him. What I want you to do is I want you to start praising God for what you want to see. Again, come on, I'm going somewhere here. So for those of you who don't believe, or you kind of sort of believe, and you're not getting the full benefits, amen, of your spiritual father, I want you to just start praying to God. God, this is what it would look like, or this is how I would know that you exist. I want you to do yourself a favor, because you're not, the fact that you believe or you don't believe, you're not hurting God, but you are hurting yourself, amen? And so let me put it in the natural for you so that you can understand it. My daughter, when she got accepted into Michigan State University, It was probably not even a full year at Michigan State University that she had made her decision that she wanted to go into social work. I remember it was spring break, and she went to a Campeche, Mexico. And I remember she came back from that experience as she had a chance to go to hospitals. She had a chance to go to some of the unfortunate communities. And she saw some things that she never saw before in America, right, that she hadn't been exposed to. And I remember she came back, and I remember she was in the kitchen crying and just saying, Dad, there were kids with cancer, and they would take my hair and pretend like it was their hair, and just the love and the joy that they had. And she was super excited. I want to put this in the natural for you. And so she came back, and she said she wanted to go into social work. We actually looked at social work. Like, we looked at what you want to do, and how can social work serve you? Not this degree. I'm not interested in degrees, but how can this degree serve? How can it set you up for it? And immediately as we began to study, we realized that she had to go to grad school. Amen. In which she was accepted into grad school. Listen to me very closely. I made it my business to do certain engagements. I made it my business to take a certain amount of money and put it to the side for her four-year degree. I made it my business to get her connected to individuals at Michigan State University. Amen. Listen to what I'm trying to tell you. Who were social work majors who had gone through the four-year program, gone through the master's program, and now work at the university. I made it my business as her father. I need you to hear what I'm saying. I made it my business, amen, to take care of her business. You're not hearing what I'm saying. And so a lot of you, because you're not taking the benefits of your spiritual father, you don't believe, or you're not letting God do what he wants to do, you're doing it on your own. And I'm trying to explain to you, amen, she didn't do it on her own. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I made sure that there were times that I sent certain prayers or certain scriptures, or I would motivate her, or I would say certain things to her to keep. Oh, you're not hearing what I'm saying. Once I found out what she wanted to do, I made it my business to support what she wanted to do. You're not hearing what I'm saying. And so when she got the letter for grad school, praise God, that she was accepted into grad school, amen, I made sure that I did what I needed to do. And I'm trying to explain to you that there is this God and you are his child, and there are certain things that he wants to do. And he told me to come tell you today he loves you. Hallelujah. And that he's tired, amen, of having this long distance relationship. Come on, somebody. And that he wants to get a closer relationship with you, and he wants you to get the benefits. Amen. Amen. Okay, I got to tell y'all this story, all right? I got to tell you this story. Jamie, unbelievable, right? Unbelievable, right? So I've been going to the grocery store, and because my wife has a compromised immune system, I'm not like going on a regular basis, like weekly or every other week, right? And so the last couple times, Jamie, I went, it was no margarine, no butter, no nothing. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And I just remember the last time I went, I just want to keep it 100 with y'all. I just want to show you the benefits of daddy. I want to show you how much he loves you, how much he cares for you, and how much he wants to make your life on this earth a beautiful life, a pleasant life. Amen. Come on. I get excited. So Jamie, I go into the store, right? And I've not done this before because sometimes, you know, I trick myself and I say, you know, don't pray about no margarine. Come on. But hey, I did something, Jamie Carr. I said, forget that. I'm about to pray. And I prayed the week of, knowing I was headed to the store on Friday, I prayed that week, God bless me with some butter. You know what I'm saying? Like, bless me with some margarine. And I almost messed up, Jamie. I almost put a message out in GroupMe, and I almost said to those individuals in our church GroupMe that if you guys go out to the store and you find butter, get your pastor some. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm just being real, Jamie. I almost sounded the alarm. I need some butter. Can somebody hook me up? And I heard God say, don't let nobody get you no butter. I want to get you butter. Come on, somebody. I heard God speak to me and say, don't call him. Don't ask them. Let me do it. And so Friday, I was getting ready to go to the grocery store. I got my mask. You know what I'm saying? I got my gloves. I got my whole little routine. And God said, do me a favor. Don't go to the store you usually go to. Come on, somebody. Come on. Come on. I want to help somebody out today. God loves you more than you could ever know it. Amen. God has forgiven you of everything you've done in the past. Amen. And God is semi-hurt. Amen. Because you're not living the life you're supposed to be living right now. God is hurt that your marriage is not what it's supposed to be, that your relationship with your kids is not what they're supposed to be, that your health is not. Like the stuff you wrote on the board, God is hurt that you're not there, and he's crying to, I'm old, Jamie, we grew up with wrestling. He like, tag me in. So God said, tag me in on the butter. don't go to that store. Go to the other store. And so I got to the other store, Jamie, and you know, my wife gave me a list. And so I'm trying to be sequential, Jamie. I'm trying to be sequential. Hey, whatever that means, right? I'm trying to do things in order. So she gives me a list, and I love it. What Dee Dee does is not only does she give me a list sometimes, but she gives me a list, Jamie, and she gives me a list based on where stuff is in the store. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so I started in produce, Jamie. I went to a different store, Jamie. So I started in the produce. Now the butter is all the way in the back. And so I started with produce, and I heard the Lord say to me clearly, hey, stop shopping and go get the butter. Stop shopping and go get the butter, son. Like, you can come back and get that stuff later. Go get the butter. I promise you, Jamie, I've been praying not just for butter. I prayed for a tub. I didn't want a stick. I didn't want to use sticks and butter. That's old school. That's my grandma. I didn't want to do that. I wanted a tub. Jamie, in the name of Jesus Christ, on everything I love, I go to the back, Jamie, I look at the butter. All the butter is gone, Jamie, and as I pay close attention, it's one tub of butter left. It's one tub of butter left. And I look and I say, this can't be. He said, boy, go get that butter. I saved that butter just for you. Amen. Hundreds of people have come through this store. There's no butter and there's no tubs of butter. only sticks. Son, I say this butter just for you. And I grabbed Joker Jamie and put that joke in the thing. And listen to me, I wasn't even excited about the butter. I was excited about the fact that the God of the universe not only heard my prayer, but I'm sure there are millions and millions of prayers going up on a regular, on a daily basis, on an hourly basis, who knows? In 60 seconds, millions of prayers might be going up. My God heard those 7 million, 8 million, 10 million prayers. And in the midst of those prayers, Jamie, he heard my prayer for butter. He heard my prayer for butter, and he didn't get my prayer mixed up with somebody else. Are you not hearing what I'm saying? He didn't get my prayer mixed up with somebody else's prayer. He heard my prayer, and he saved butter for his... He said, butter is a light thing. Amen. Butter is a light thing. But God knew that I wanted to butter my toast, Jamie. He knew I wanted to put a little butter in my grits, Jamie. Hallelujah. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? He knew that I wanted to make a 7-layer burrito, and I wanted to be able to put a little butter on at the bottom of the pan, and I wanted to get my burrito crispy. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? I'm telling you today that God loves you. I'm telling you today that you're special in God's eye. I'm telling you, if your mama don't want you and your daddy don't want you, I'm telling you, if your teacher can't stand you, I'm telling you, if your boss don't like you, if you're getting on your husband's nerve, that has nothing to do with God. God loves you and he wants you. He told me to tell you that today. He told me to tell you he loves you, he wants you, and he wants you to be happy. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm coming to tell you that today. Amen. Amen. Now, do me a favor. I never say share messages. Like, that's not my MO, but you got to share this message. Let me tell you something. This is what God, go get a piece of paper, write this down. This is the message that God told me to give you today. I want you to do me a favor. Don't be spoiled. For those of you who are already blessed, I want you to think of your son, your daughter, your brother, your sister. I want you to think about somebody else that you could get his message to. Hallelujah. Amen. So don't just be like, I'm already there. I'm on that level already. I don't need it. You may not need this message for you, but you might need this message for somebody you know. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I've never asked you to share a message since you've been with me, but I'm going to ask you to share this message. It's been on my heart for the last 3 weeks, and God loves you so much that he didn't even want me to give it to you until it was properly prepared. Amen. So are you ready to go? Now, this first one, I wanted to show you this first one. This first one, praise God. For those of you who claim that you're not, you know, religious, I get it. You're not spiritual. Listen to me, like, you don't believe in God. You do things on your own. Don't do that. I want you to give God a chance, and I want you to look at this image. If you can see this image of this little boy, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. What happens is when you get in a relationship, and some of you, unfortunately, and I want you to pray about it, you've been in some very toxic, selfish relationships. Like you've been in, it's only one way for there to be a bad relationship. A bad relationship, amen, is when the person, what Carl calls it, self-gratification. When you're in a relationship with a person and all that person wants is their desires to be met. Like, that's all they care about. They think about them. They don't us. Amen. And I'm not even suggesting that people think about themselves and think about you. That's not what I'm talking about. But in a healthy relationship, praise God, in a healthy relationship, and a lot of people haven't been in one, so they don't understand what it looks like. But in a healthy relationship, it's not about me, it's not about you, it's about we, it's about us. In a healthy relationship, come on. I was talking to Dr. Downs, right? And he was breaking that thing down to me. Listen to me very closely. It's not about you, it's not about you. And so some of you go, you bow before, what is that? Listen to me, when you get in a loving relationship, when you get in a relationship where that person got your back and you got their back, oh, come on. You don't mind bowing down. Amen. You don't. And watch this. What I love about the kid is that not only does he know the power of God, watch this though, Jamie. Not only does he know the power of God, he got everything that's in his house. Everything that he has control of, he got that bowing down before him as well. I used to tell my kids all the time, I don't care what you do when you become an adult, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Because everything we have, everything we own, everything that has happened for us and to us has been by the grace of God. And so listen to me very closely. I want you to get to a point in your life, hallelujah, where you try God. And I'm telling you, if you try him, and if you let God get in your affairs, you let God get in your mouth, you let God get in your heart, you let God get in your mind, you let God get in every fiber of your life, you're going to have different outcomes. Amen. So, all right, so let's get started. Amen, let's get started. All right, so this is how much God loves you. Hallelujah. This is how much God loves you. So we're talking about habit stacking. I had this for a while. We talk about habit stacking. All right, habit stacking. All right. All right, watch this. I got to slow down. I'm super excited, Jamie. Listen to me. I got to get this to you because if you're not where you want to be, but listen to me very closely, and I just got to be 100 with you. If you're not where you want to be in your marriage, if you're not where you want to be in your fitness, if you're not where you want to be in your finance, if you're not where you want to be in your family, like whatever it is, you're not there, you're not having the type of fun, it's your fault, it's not God's fault. Please write that down, because we got to get to the root of this. We got to get to the core of this. Your inability to be where you're supposed to be, amen, even in COVID-19, if somebody laid you off and you ain't got no money, you broke, if you're not happy in COVID-19, like, it's not God's fault, I promise you. And I'm going to show it to you, but you got to do me a favor. You got to take ownership, right? Now, here's what Jamie, God loves the people who are watching so much. I went running this morning, Jamie. I got my own playlist, Jamie. God wouldn't let me use my own playlist. God said, don't play that today. I said, what? I got a routine. Like, I'm trying to put in 6 miles today. I need that right music. I said, don't do that for me. What I want you to do today, I want you to listen to Anita Baker. I said, Anita Baker? Anita Baker? You want me to run to Anita Baker, God, this morning before church? You want me to get Anita Baker in my spirit? God said, I'm going to need you to listen to Anita Baker. So I'm running, Jamie. I'm running. I get the first Anita Baker. Angel, oh, angel. I get angel in my spirit. I'm like, angel, come on. And then another one, 365 days in. And then God hit me with, I said, ooh. I put it on repeat, Jamie. I put it on repeat. And I kept hearing Anita Baker. I'm sorry. I kept hearing God say, tell my people, I believe it's going to be what you want it to be. Write it down. Habit stacking. Write it down. This is what God told me to tell you. Right? I wrote this down for my daughter. I wrote this down for my son. And I wrote this down for a division of my company. I want you to hear what I'm saying. I want you to give it a designation. God just gave me a word to give to you. Anita Baker, I heard her say it, but I heard the Spirit of the living God say, I believe this is going to be what you want it to be. God said, I don't know if you're going to be alive. I just kept seeing people. I don't know if you're going to make it till you 50 or till you 60 or till you 70. If you're going to die at 80 years old, I don't know. But I heard God say, tell my babies that this life, that your marriage, your fight, I believe it's going to be what you want it to be. You're not a victim. Stuff is not happening to you by happenstance. You don't have to accept certain things no more. Listen to me. I heard God tell me through Anita Baker to tell you, I believe this is going to be what you want it to be. Oh, you're not hearing me. And if there's an area of your life that is not where you want it to be, it's because you're not habit stacking. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You're not habit stacking. Hallelujah. Jamie, let's go to the next one. Come on, make sure you pass this message on to somebody. I want to help you out in the name of Jesus. I want to help you out. 2 Peter, we'll start. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's start at 2 Peter 1 and verse 5. Amen, amen. Watch this. For this very reason, praise God. Circle the scriptures. I'm not giving you scriptures to hear myself. I'm not just trying to talk. I'm not trying to waste 12 o'clock, 11 o'clock, no. Saturday 11, Saturday 12. I'm not trying to waste your time. I'm not trying to waste my time. I'm not trying to waste God's time. I want you to look at the scripture. We're starting off with this. We're starting off with, I believe it's going to be what you want it to be. I believe. Oh, come on. I believe. So, Jamie, they called me and said that they want to close. They want to close on the house in May. And they told me that they want us to do a virtual walkthrough, Jamie. I said, a what? They said a virtual walkthrough. I said, come on. This is our home. It's a dream home. Ain't nobody about to do no virtual walkthrough. There's no way I'm going to be able to see the fine details of the, I'm not going to be able to touch the walls to see if the wall, I'm not going to be able to look at the color of the paint and make sure that, I want you to hear me. God loves you so much. I believe it's going to be what you want it to be. And so as we begin to talk, of course, Jamie, I get it. It's a construction company. Guess what they want to do? They want to build all the houses in the subdivision. And guess what they want to do next? They want to move on to the next ones. Are you not hearing what I'm saying? There are people that they're gonna get a check once we close. I get it, but listen to me. But God said, son, don't tell her what she want to hear. Tell this your house. You're not hearing what I'm saying. This is your house. This is where you and your wife are gonna live. This is your home. Hallelujah! In the name of Jesus. You tell her that you want to wait until the end of May when they're starting to release, but you need a full 30 days after everything is over to make sure it's clear. Oh, come on. Are you hearing me? I believe it's going to be what you want it to be. It's not what they want it to be. It's not what the real estate company wanted to be. It's not what the real estate realtor wanted to be. It's not what the construction company wanted. It's not what the bank wanted to be. That's my house. It's what we want it to be. When are you going to finally wake up and realize that you only have so many years left and that God's trying to bless you? God's trying to hook you up. God wants to take your life to a whole other level. When are you going to get to a point where you're saying, God, I believe it's going to be what you want it to be? Are you ready? Are you ready? I said, do me a favor. Let them know, my wife and I, we not coming to June. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing what I'm trying to tell you? You sitting here going through all this hell. You sitting here living this average life. You sitting here dealing with all of these issues because you made a decision that's what you're going to accept. And I'm telling you today, God told me to tell you he loves you and he don't want you to accept the marginal life no more. He don't want you to... Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, watch this, Jamie. Watch this, Jamie. God gave me this text and I ain't even see this when he gave me. For this very reason, I get up and speak so my daughter could go to school. For this very reason, I get up and do what I do so my son could go to Michigan State. For this very reason, I went to Michigan State University and not only graduated, I worked at the university. I kept my name clean. For this very reason, because I knew that if my name got messed up, what the Bible says, what's better than riches? What's better than wealth? A man's name. And so I kept my name clean so that when my babies came behind my name, when my babies came behind my name, when they came to Michigan State, that there would be blessings that they would get because of my name. And for this very reason, are you hearing what I'm saying? I get up and speak so my wife never has to go back to work again. For this very reason, the Bible says. What are you doing this for? The reason why some of you are not having the life you want and you don't have the life that God has for you because you don't even know the reason. For this very reason. Make every effort, circle that for me, please. I am sick and tired of people calling me. I'm sick and tired of doing counseling and people are not putting forth the effort. Okay, all right. Look, I'm telling y'all, I'm so discouraged as a counselor. You know, people, oh man, I promise you, people are calling me and Jamie, I'm almost thinking that people are worshiping the problem. They worshiping the problem. Watch what the Bible says. For this very reason, make every effort to add. Make every effort. Oh, you're not hearing what I'm saying. Make every effort. An effort. Make an effort. And there are people who are calling me, and I can tell when they're calling me. I don't care if it's marriages. I don't care if it's about business. I don't care if it's about their health. I don't care if it's about their finances. They calling me, and they not making no efforts. You ain't making no efforts. It's like you almost, it's like you using your energy to be unhappy. Right? Down. I said it. I'm gonna say it again. You are making every effort to be unhappy. You why? Because every single time you call, you calling about the problem. You ain't trying to. You're making every effort. You're using all your prayer for the problem. You're using all your energy for the problem. You're using all your strength for the problem. For this very reason, make every effort to add habit stacking. Add. All right. Let me say it in the natural so you get it. So when Didi was like, enough is enough, like the arguing, like, you know, you arguing, whatever, you fussing and fight. Watch this, Jamie. I promise you in the name of Jesus Christ, Didi didn't call her best friend. Because I want to make it practical as we get into the word. Habit stacking. Didi never called her best friend and said, Eric arguing, Eric, well. She didn't call her mama. I can't believe Eric, she didn't call Jalen. She didn't call Jay. She called CJ. You know why she called CJ, Jamie? She called CJ because she was actually trying to solve the problem. You calling your best friend because you ain't trying to solve the problem in the first place. That's why you calling them. You know doggone well calling your best friend ain't about to change nothing. You didn't call the counselor. You ain't called the pastor. You call your best friend. You call your sister, you call your brother, you call your homeboy. Why? Because you wanted sympathy. You ain't ready to habit stack. You ain't ready to solve the problem. I am sick and tired of people calling. Somebody called me the other day and it was like, I'm so mad that my spouse call you. Why they call you? I'm so mad. I'm like, yo, I'm mad too. I'm going to say it again, Jamie. They say, every time we get into it, they call you. Every time they get into it, I'm sick of them calling you. I'm sick and tired of you. I'm like embarrassed. I'm sick and tired. I say, I'm sick and tired too. But I'm not sick and tired of you calling me. I want you to call me. You think my marriage got here because we didn't call somebody? You think we got here because we didn't go to a counselor? You think we got here without reading books? You think we got here without going to conferences? You think we got here without talking to the elders? You think we got here without wisdom? What I'm tired of is I'm sick and tired of you calling me and not trying to do nothing about what you're going through. That's what I'm sick and tired of. I'm sick and tired of she mad at you, you mad at her. I'm sick and tired of y'all not using your energy to fight the problem instead of fighting each other. Are you really trying to get to the next level or not? And the Bible says the way to do it is to habit stack. For this very reason, make every effort, circle that, not every excuse. I'm tired of people talking about what happened when they was 12. You ain't 12 no more. You ain't 13 no more. My mama, my daddy, you 40 years old. You about 30 years removed from 12 years old. You about 30 years removed from 15. You about 30 years removed from 18. You still talking about what happened to you when you was 12. Like that person still got power over you. Like that person, the person you talking about, you probably don't see that person on a regular basis. That person ain't sleeping with you. That person ain't paying your bills. That person ain't helping you make decisions. When you gonna stop making excuses and start putting forth effort? He says, for this very reason, whatever you trying to do, whatever you trying to accomplish, whatever you trying to do, I want you to. I want you to be happy. I want you to be healthy. I want you to soar. I want you to live your best life. But in order to do it, you're going to have to make every effort to add. Watch this, Jamie. Add to your faith goodness. And to your goodness, knowledge. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And to your knowledge, self-control. And to self-control, perseverance. And to perseverance, godliness. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Habit stacking. Habit stacking, and to your godliness, mutual affection, and to mutual affection, love. For if you possess these qualities in increasing, in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective. Is this not the word of God? Is this not COVID-19? Is this not him? Is this not a solution for COVID-19? For if you possess these qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective, from being broke. They will keep you from being broke. They will keep you and your spouse from getting into it. They will keep your kids from being unproductive. From being ineffective and unproductive in your knowledge of our Lord. Give me that habit stacking, Jamie. Give me that habit stacking. Come on, come on. Give me that. Matter of fact, yep. Again, the reason habit stacking works so well is that your current habits are already built into your brain. Oh, I'm gonna preach today. Somebody gonna get free today. Somebody gonna get free today. Somebody, you're not gonna be talking about the same stuff in 2021 that you was talking about. It get on my nerve. Some of y'all calling me. We talking about the same stuff we was talking about 4 years ago. As if you were a lion or a bear or an eagle. God, you were created a little lower than the angels. You were made in the image of God. You can make decisions. You have power and authority that animals and beasts don't have. And you still talking about what you was talking about in 2012. Y'all still fighting about the exact same thing. Listen to me. The reason why Didi called CJ is because Didi knew when she got off the phone with CJ, and as CJ called me, she knew that She knew we were about to do some self-assessing and I was going to get on the other side of it. She didn't call CJ because she wanted to whine. She didn't call CJ because she wanted to complain. She didn't call CJ because she wanted to make me look stupid. She didn't call CJ because she wanted me to look bad. She called CJ because she wanted a solution to the problem. It wasn't about me. It wasn't about her. It was about the problem. The ineffective communication, and she wanted to get on the other side of the ineffective communication. Why? Because she does love me. I wasn't her enemy. She didn't go 4 weeks without talking to me. She wasn't pissed off. She wasn't mad at me. Oh, y'all not hear what I'm saying, Jamie. She wasn't mad at me. She was mad at the problem, and she wanted to fix the problem. How do you fix the problem? You have it stat. Okay, I'm sorry. You have patterns and behaviors that have been strengthened over years. Habit stacking increases the likelihood that you'll stick with a habit by stacking your new behavior on top of the old behavior. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you listening to me? The problem with most of you is you still bragging. You're bragging as a father about how you work and provide for your family. You're bragging as a father about how you take care of your kids. You're bragging as a father about how great. That has nothing to do with being a husband. You got that down pat. That's good. Add something to it. Add something to it. You're bragging about how much money you're making for this company. Now all of a sudden that company is gone in COVID-19 and you only have one stream of income. Add, habit stacking. You got something that you're great at. If you got something that you're great at, don't keep worshiping the one thing that you're great at, because the thing that you're great at is going to attract stuff to you. It will bring, but it can't take you to the next level. And the problem with most of you is you worship what you're good at. Listen to me very closely. I'm so sick and tired of doing marital counsel. I'm so sick and tired of doing business counsel. I'm so sick and tired of there being a problem and people want to tell me all the great stuff they did in the past, all the stuff. That has nothing to do with, I'm a great person and I'm loyal and I got degree. That's phenomenal. That's what got you to the company. That's what got you to the marriage. But that ain't about to take you to the next level. Stop bragging about what you great at and what you good at. And let's focus on what you not good at. Not to embarrass you or make you look bad, but to strengthen you in that area. And so habit stacking means that you are great at some things, that you are phenomenal at some things. But in order to keep those things, oh, come on. Okay, let me make it plain, Jamie. So you a great father. So you a great husband. You a great father. You a great mother. But y'all can't stand each other in the marriage. You know what that's going to do? What's going to happen is y'all might end up getting separated or getting divorced. And guess what that's going to do? That's not going to allow you to be there for your babies the way you want to be there for your baby. Am I making sense? You a great father. Brag about it. You a great mother. Brag about it. You go to work and provide your kids. Brag about it. But the fact that your marriage sucks is going to affect. It's going to affect, even if you don't get separated or you don't get a divorce, all that negative energy is going to affect the children. So do me a favor. Stop bragging about how good of a father you are, how good of a mother you are, how good of a provider you are. Stop bragging and start habit stacking. What my wife was saying was, man, I know you love me with all your heart. I know you're a great provider. I see what you do for your kids. I know what you are to the world. But you don't communicate effectively. And that has nothing to do with nothing else. Every time we get into we discuss an issue that we don't see eye to eye on, you escalate. That's something you need to fix. Again, the real reason habit stacking works so well is that your current habits already are built into your brain. You got those. You got those. E, you're a phenomenal speaker. You make good money. But when Josh was introduced to my life and Jamal was introduced to my life, Jamal said to me, E.T., you need to get into real estate. I'm like, bro, I don't need to get into real estate. Like, I speak for a living. I make good money doing what I'm doing. I don't need no real estate. He said, E.T., here's the problem. You speak well. You do a phenomenal job. But the only way you get to make money is actually speaking. And if something happens to you, your babies can't necessarily do what you do and make what you make. With real estate, which you already doing, I'm like, what do you mean I'm already doing? He like, you already, Jamie, he said you already got a habit in real estate. I was like, what do you mean by that? You already paying people. You got an apartment. You got a house. You got two houses. Your son got an apartment. Your daughter got an apartment. You already in real estate. You already in real estate. Now habit stack. Now get on the other side of it. Instead of paying somebody rent, have somebody pay you rent. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Habit stack. Habit stack. Habit stack. You a high school dropout? You got a GED. Habit stack. Add the 4-year to it. Habit stack. Add the master's to it. Habit stack. Add the PhD to it. Habit stack. Add the disc. Habit stack. Add the attributes. Habit stack. Add the values. Habit stack. Let me tell y'all something. I'm going to be truthful with you. I added a vocal coach. Do you know that my vocal coach didn't give me this voice? Do you know my vocal coach didn't teach me how to speak? But do you know when my vocal coach came in that she taught me how to preserve my voice? Do you know that my vocal coach said, if you got to speak on Saturday morning at 11 o'clock, and this is one of the most important presentations you're going to give, stop speaking on Friday. Stop speaking on Friday. Matter of fact, you need to stop talking altogether. Preserve your voice. Are you habit stacking? Habit stacking. So that week when I lost my voice and I had to pray, and y'all prayed me when I got it back, I wasn't using the skill set that she gave me. And when I messed up, let me show you this. So I told you what habit stacking is. Let me tell you when we habit stack. Jamie, can you play that for me? Let me show you when we habit stack.
Instead of us all going on vacation, we all showed up and we started working out. And everybody, starting with Michael, changed.
Did you hear? Okay, all right. So let me paint the picture for you. Habit stacking, write it down. Teach your daughter how to do it. Teach your son how to do it. Teach your husband how to do it. Teach your wife. Habit stacking. Habit stacking is how you blow up. God gave me this gift from birth, but when I got the GED, it took me to another level. The 4-year degree, a whole nother level. The master's degree, a whole nother level. The PhD, a whole habit stacking. We start writing books, another level. There was a discipline that came out of writing books. Start doing assessments. CJ would say, the inability to self-assess. So I started assessing. I started habit stacking. I didn't get here off a gift. I got here habit stacking. And BJ Armstrong said it. He said when they lost to the Pistons in Game 7, they felt in their spirit they could have won that game. They felt that they were just as good as the Pistons that year. He said when they lost, they went in the locker room and they did not get in the shower and get on that bus. They did not get on the bus and fly back home. He said they stayed in that locker room. I'm telling you, you got to get to a point where you say enough is enough. Enough crying, enough murmuring, enough complaining, enough pain. I got to use all my energy to get what I know I deserve to get, to be who I can be, to have what I can have. You got a habit stack. He said eventually they got on that plane. And when they got home and they got to the United Center, they said that they didn't do what they normally do. They didn't go home. They didn't go on vacation. They deserved a vacation. They played 82 games plus some playoffs. They deserved to be with their family. They deserved, but you know what they did? They created their own quarantine, and they quarantined themselves. They quarantined themselves, and they didn't go nowhere. And they came to that doggone practice facility every single day. And Michael Jordan, who did not want to do it, Michael Jordan decided to put the weights on. He said that the Pistons are physical, and that the Pistons are killing me, and that the Pistons are beating us down. And so what we got to do, habit stack. We got to add muscle. Michael Jordan had never added muscle in his life. He had never lift weights in his life. I'm telling you today, the reason why you can't get past the Pistons of your life, the reason why you can't win Game 7, the reason why you can't get to the next level is because you're so good at what you're good at. Oh, you missed what I just said. You worship the fact that you could put up 50 points. You worship the fact that you can win a dunk contest. You worship the fact that you can go to the All-Star game and be Mr. All-Star. You worship the fact that you could take a team that never went to the playoffs, you could take them to the playoffs. You worship the fact that you could put up 61 points. You worship the fact that you won the scoring title, but that's not what you're playing for. Phil Jackson said that ain't what we're here for. You're here to win a championship. And God is challenging you and saying, you ain't just here to get no house. You ain't here just to buy no car. You ain't here just to live in a nice neighborhood. You ain't here just to be a professional. You ain't here to get those titles. I called you. I birthed you to do something unique and special. And you're going to get that and you're going to get some more. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And it's time for you to start picking up the weights. What are the weights? Write it down. What are the weights in your life that you need to pick up to take yourself past the Pistons? You heard what I said. What are the weights that you need to pick up? What are the things you need to do? I'm going to be transparent with y'all. formal education. And I, listen to me, I don't even have to be transparent. Y'all know, if you come to my conference, if you listen to the podcast, oh, I promise you, it's like PTI, CJ, bless his heart. He like, yo, E, I'm saying words that don't even exist. The hardest thing that I've ever done in my life is formal education. I dropped out of school because I hated school. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When I tell y'all, growing up in Detroit in a predominantly black city, and then going to Michigan State University, I used to be the only African-American male in some of my classes. And when you talk about embarrassment, but I had Jamie, I had to get past embarrassment. Jamie, you think when I'm on stage or I'm on the podcast, you think that's correction. You ain't seen correction to a teacher is correcting me 10 years ago on some stuff. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And I remember at first being embarrassed. And I remember people looking at me, you know, and I'm thinking, man, these people are thinking I'm stupid, I'm dumb. And I remember I got past the point of embarrassment. Oh, you not hearing what I'm saying? I got past my pistons. I say, I'll be as embarrassed as you want. I ain't sleeping with y'all. Y'all ain't paying my bills. I don't even know why I care about what y'all think. And I'm going to put my hand up, and I'm going to say some stuff, Jamie, that's going to sound stupid, but she going to correct me, and I'm going to get better and better and better and better. And now we changing school districts, and now we writing books that are changing school. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I had to get past my pistons. I had to lift those weights. And I promise you, even today, when it comes to formal education, I'm not comfortable with it. I don't like it, but I got a habit stack. And I'd rather habit stack and get to the next level than to brag about the gifts that I have and stay stuck where I am. Are you tired? Enough is enough. I'm not mad with counseling when they call me and say they're having a problem. I'm mad when you got the same problem 5-6 years and you want to talk about that problem. Like, listen to me very closely. You're using your energy to be unhappy. You're using your energy to be unhappy. You're talking to people that ain't going to help you fix it. You're doing stuff that's going to exacerbate it. When are you going to get tired? When are you going to say enough is enough? And like B.J. Armstrong said, oh, we was hurt. We was in pain. But not the type of pain that's going to make me cry. Not the type of pain that's going to make me get under the covers and hide myself. Not the pain that's going to cause me to withdraw so I don't have to talk to nobody else. Not that type of pain, but the type of pain that's going to make you go in the weight room and get better and get stronger. Oh, come on, stronger, bigger, better, with broader show. When are you going to get to the... When are you going to get in the weight room and start habit stacking? When are you going to stop crying? When are you going to stop murmuring? When are you going to stop being defeated? When are you going to start acting like, oh, you a victim and woe is me? I'm telling you, I got time for you and all your problems if you want a solution. But if you want self-gratification versus self-sacrifice, I don't got time for you. All right, now as we leave, habit stacking. I gave you exhibit A of what habit stacking was. Now let me give you exhibit B of what habit stacking isn't. Hallelujah. Samson. Come on, show me that. Come on, show me that. I just want him to see it, Jamie. Let it stick there for a while. When we talk about strength, the Bible declares that there was never a man as strong as Samson, but he didn't habit stack. Oh, come on, I want to help somebody. I tried to show you what it looked like first with the Chicago Bulls. They won 6 titles after that. After Mike got into the weight room and made some adjustments. I'm tired of you talking about your marriage. When are you going to make some adjustments? I'm tired of you talking about your bank account. When are you going to make? I'm tired of you talking about your fitness. When are you going to get your butt up and put on some workout clothes and go work out? When are you going to change your diet? You know you can, right? You know you can have a healthy, happy marriage, right? You know it can be blissful, right? But it can't be without you. You know you can make as much money as you want, right? I just found out that Bill Gates in COVID-19, Jamie, he lost $40.8 billion. You mean to tell me he lost $40.8 billion and you can't make a couple? Are you hearing what I'm saying? I told my staff, listen to me, y'all super talented, super talented. I was talking to the leader. Y'all super talented. Y'all super anointed. Y'all pray. Y'all got degrees among you. Do me a favor. Y'all gifted and talented. Go be gifted and talented. Hallelujah. I'm talking to you right now. Stop talking about COVID-19. Stop talking about the coronavirus. I need you to do me a huge favor. Go be unique because you are. Go be special because you are. Go be phenomenal because you are. Go be great because you are. Stop talking about your marriage like it ain't nothing you can do about it. Stop talking about your fitness like it ain't nothing you can do about it. Stop talking about your finances like it ain't nothing you can do about it. Stop whining and crying and complaining. Stop pointing the doggone finger at somebody else. Go look at the doggone mirror how phenomenal you are. Go look at how great you are. Go look how wonderful you are. You done made it in COVID-19. You still here in COVID-19. The best is not yet to come. Come on, stop whining and complaining. And be the phenomenal man and woman God created you to be. Be the phenomenal husband you capable of. The phenomenal wife you capable of. Don't you ever complain again. You use all that energy to add to. Add to your faith. Your problem is you got some faith. Now you walk around here bragging about your faith. Add to your faith goodness. Are you hearing me? Add to your goodness patience. Come on, add to. Are you? God said add to your GED. I know you're excited about it, but we ain't about to stop with no GED. Add now the four-year degree. I know you geeked about the add the master's. Are you hearing me? Some of you stuck in the same spot because you ain't put no effort for it. Yep, you want it. You say you want it. You say you want change. You say you want better, but you're not adding to. Watch this. And Samson went down to Timnah together with his father and his mother. And as they approached the vineyard of Timnah, suddenly a young lion came roaring towards him. And the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon him, so that he tore the lion apart with his bare hands, Jamie, as he might have torn a young goat. But he told neither his father nor his mother what he had done. And as he approached Lehi, the Philistines came toward him shouting. The Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon him. The ropes on his arms became like charred flax, and the bindings dropped from his hands. Finding a flesh bone of a donkey, he grabbed it and struck down 1,000 men by himself. Then Samson said, with a donkey's jawbone, I have made donkeys of them. And with the donkey's jawbone, I have killed 1,000 men. Oh, my, my, my. I'm about to let y'all go. I know, I'm about to let y'all go. I'm about to let you, I'm about to let you go, but I'm about to show you what it looks like when you brag about your strengths, when you brag about where you're strong at in one area, but you don't have it stacked. I've been wanting to share this with you for 3 weeks. Whatever you want, you can have it, but you can't have it with self-gratification. You can only have it with self-sacrifice. You can't have it just bragging about who you are and what you are. You can't brag about what who you are got you to where you want to be, but it ain't going to take you where you're going. That little junk might have worked. That little junk you did might have worked to attract him or her. It might have worked in dating. But I'm going to tell you this, it won't work in marriage. Oh, that stuff you did to get that four-year degree, the little stuff you did, oh, I promise you, it's going to help you to get the degree. It ain't going to help you to get the job. Habit stack. Bible says, increasingly add to your. Watch this. Samson had strength, but he didn't habit stack. Let's see what happens when you don't habit stack. And sometime later, he fell in love with a woman in the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The ruler of the Philistines went to her and said, see if you can lure him into showing you the secret of his great strength. Not only did he have great strength, family, everybody knew. He was so strong, everybody knew he was strong. Oh, it ain't that people don't know that you're strong. When we strong, people know where we strong. They know where we gifted. That don't nobody need to affirm you and pub you up and tell you how great you are. We already know how great you are. The question is, are you going to habit stack? Samson decided not to habit stack. He decided to rely on one strength or strength in one area. How can we overpower him so we may tie him up and subdue him? Each one of us will give you 1,100 shekels of silver. And so Delilah said to Samson, tell me the strength, the secret of your great strength, and how you can be tied up and subdued. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. When you strong in one area, you don't happy stack. You strong in one area and super stupid in the other one. Super dumb. Listen to me. Delilah didn't even play with it. This is what happened when you don't happy stack. You thinking because you strong in one area that it just lends itself to the other area. It don't work like that. Now, sister girl ain't even playing. She didn't came straight up to my man, was like, yo, bro, let's stop playing game. Give me the secret to your strength. I need to know right now. My man's so dumb, so strong and smart in one area, but yet so weak and dumb in the other one. You better habit stack if you want to keep your marriage. You want a habit stack if you don't want to be in a marriage for 20 years and have it. I heard one husband tell me once, Jamie, he said, I'm going to divorce my wife as soon as these kids grow up. I'm like, wow, you just going to 18 it out and you got four kids, so it's going to be a minute. So you're just going to go 20 years of just pure hell. You just can't find a way to use that same energy and get counseling or something and get. And Sam, oh, this is a dumb part. And Samson answered her. Yo, it's at this part, you should have probably bounced. It's at this part, you should have probably been like, and why do you want to know the secret to my strength? Like, you should have been asking questions. But he was physically strong, Jamie, but he was sexually weak. He was physically strong, but sexually weak. Well, if anyone taught, he was so strung out, that sex had become such a god to him that he could no longer hear from God. And now he entertaining the devil. If anyone ties me with seven fresh bowstrings that have not been dried, I'll become as weak as other men. And then the rulers of the Philistine brought her seven fresh bowstrings that had never been dried. And she tied him with them. And when the men hid in the room, she called to him, Samson, the Philistines are upon us. He snapped the bowstrings as easily as a piece of string snaps when it comes to a flame. So the secret of his strength was not discovered. Amen. Praise God. God loves the boy so much that he spared him once. Then Delilah said to Samson, you've made a fool of me. Now she put it on her. Now it's about her now. And so now Samson is, come to me now. Tell me how you can be tied. And he said, if anyone ties me securely with new ropes that have never been used, I'll become as weak as any other man. So Delilah took new ropes. Habit stacking. You got a habit stack. That strength will take you so far, but it will take you to your grave. And so Delilah took new ropes and tied them with them. Then, with men hidden again in the room, she calls to him, Samson, the Philistines are upon you. But he snapped the ropes of his arms as if they were threads. But he's still there, y'all. Still there. All the strength of the world, physically, but sexually weak. And Delilah says to Samson, all this time you've been making a fool of me and lying to me. Tell me how you can be tied. Now, at what point don't he think she's serious? And Samson said, if you weave seven braids of my head into the fabric of a loom and tighten it with a pin, I'll be as weak as any other man. So while he was sleeping, Delilah took, bruh, how are you sleeping in the midst? What kind of sex is this? Come on. What kind of sex? What are you doing? What kind of spell she got on you? That not only are you telling her the secret, you done fell asleep in her leg. And so while he was sleeping, Delilah took the seven braids of his head, wove them into a fabric, and tightened it with a pin. And she called to him, Samson, the Philistine is upon you. He woke from his sleep and pulled up the pin and the loom with the fabric. Then she said to him, how can you say you love me when you wouldn't confide in me? This is the third time you have made a fool of me and haven't told me the secret of your great strength. Three strikes the Lord gave his boy. Three times God gave him grace. And with such nagging, she prodded him day after day until he was sick to death of it. And so he told her everything. No razor. And he told her, he telling her now the stuff that only should be shared between him and God, between his parents. His parents knew it. Nobody else even knew this. And now here he is with a stranger, sharing stuff with a stranger that he shouldn't be sharing. And no razor has ever been used on my head, he said, because I have been a Nazarite, dedicated to God from my mother's womb. If my head were shaved, my strength would leave me, and I would become weak as any other man. Habit stacking. He was sexually weak, started running his mouth. And when Delilah saw that he had told her everything, she sent word to the rulers of the Philistines, come back once more. He has told me everything. And so the rulers of the Philistines returned with the silver in their hands. And after putting him to sleep on her lap, she called for someone to shave off his seven braids of his hair. And so began to subdue him, and his strength had left him. This is where some of you are right now. This is where some of you are right now in your life. This is where some of you are. You at the point right now where you didn't habit stack, you relied on one stack, one strength, and now you didn't find yourself in the enemy's lap, sleep, and the enemy is cutting your hair, stripping you of your strength while you sleep. And the grace of God has departed from you. God can't talk to you at this point. Your mama can't, you ain't said nothing to your mama, the daddy about it. And now you done found yourself sleeping with the enemy because you ain't habit stack. And you're looking at COVID-19 and you wondering what's wrong. You didn't habit stack. You had one area that you strong. Let's close it out. Let's close it out. Then she called, Samson, the Philistines are upon you. He woke from his sleep and thought, I will go out as before, Jamie. How you think you gonna go out as before when you done told? And shake myself free. But he did not know that the Lord had left him. And then the Philistines seized him, gouged out his eyes, and took him down to Gaza. Binding him with bronze shackles, they set him to grinding grains in prison. He went from being the judge of Israel. He went from being God's appointed and anointed to now he's a slave, blind, picking for the enemy. The person that he was supposed to save Israel from, now he's a slave too. But the hair on his head began to grow again after it had been shaved. Listen to me. I'm going to let you go. It's late. Habit stacking. I've been trying to do this for 3 weeks. Habit stacking. I'm trying to tell you. Jamie, let's go back. 1 Peter 2:5. Let's go back. I just want to show you. Let's go back. 5, please. For this very reason, make every effort to add. I know you think you sweet where you are. But where you are, you sweet enough. But for every new level, there are new devils. And you need to add, because every level you go to, you're going to need to be greater. Michael Jordan had to do it, and he and the Chicago Bulls did it. Samson never added and became a slave. He was physically strong, but sexually weak. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness. And then once you get the faith and the goodness, Jamie, don't stop there. Add knowledge. Let's keep going. And then once you add knowledge, let's get some self-control. Samson didn't get the self-control. He had knowledge. He knew where his strength came from. But he had no self-control. And then once you get self-control, you're going to need a little perseverance. And then once you get perseverance, You're going to need some godliness. So everybody talk, I ain't spiritual. I don't really do the church thing. There's levels. And without godliness, there are going to be some things. Without self-control, there's some of you, you know what? You are so upset right now. You upset with God, you should be upset with yourself. You so upset you haven't got to the next level. But just be real with yourself. You sweet at certain things and you ain't added nothing to it in the last 5, 6 years. You've added nothing. You've added nothing. You ain't got no more self-control than you had 10 years ago. You have no more knowledge than you had. You have no more perseverance. Like, you upset because you're not where you want to be in the time frame you thought you should be there. You have no perseverance. And watch this. To your godliness, mutual. Jamie, don't I talk about that word all the time? This is why certain businesses don't make it. This is why certain marriages don't make it. Because it ain't mutual. It's all about you and what you want to make you happy. It's not mutual. That's kids' play. You don't get to this level on some kids' play. It's mutual affection. Not affection, mutual. Let me tell you something. I was talking to a couple, Jamie, and I end with this. I just had to ask the question. I'm like, yo, for real, what's the problem? Watch this, Jamie. Blew my mind. Dee Dee and I both were on the call. You know what this person said? They said, man, I can't do this marriage thing because she got to have it her way all the time. You know what Dee Dee said, Jamie? I got to have it my way all the time, too. We got the same problem. Both of our wives got to have it their way. But I don't see it in a bad way, Jamie. I see it as mutual affection. So I'm going to give you your way. And I guarantee you right now on everything I love, there is nothing my wife will deny me of if I tell her I need it. Why? Mutual affection. And what you're trying to do is make that person give you what you want without you giving that person what they want. You like, you go first. No, you go first. It don't work like that. After you get godliness, then you add mutual affection. And after mutual affection, love. And what's love? Love, it keeps no record of wrong. Love, it hopes all things, believes all things. Love never fails. It endures all things. Are you hearing what I'm trying to explain to you? Your problem is you're not adding. Watch this, though. For if you possess these qualities. So when you leave, just go back and look at this stuff you're supposed to add. And if you ain't got it, add it. An increasing, watch this, though, Jamie. Notice that it didn't say if you add these qualities. It says if you add these qualities in increasing measure. So the Michael Jordan that won 6 championships wasn't the Michael Jordan who played for the first 7 years. It was a different Michael Jordan. It was a different Michael Jordan with a totally different philosophy. He wasn't scoring 50 no more. He was playing offense, defense. He was playing in his role. Are you not hearing what I'm saying? You're trying to be the same person you've been, but yet you're trying to get to another level, and you envy the people who are on another level when you're not willing to make the sacrifices they're willing to make. They will keep you from being ineffective and unproductive in your knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, I come now in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, I pray for every individual, Lord, who's not gotten to a point. Oh, praise God, I got to sit down. Hallelujah. I'm sorry, Jamie. I got to sit down. Hallelujah. We're about to pray. We're about to pray. Here's where I need the spirit. Hallelujah. I need the spirit of B.J. Armstrong on you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I need the spirit of B.J. Armstrong. I need the spirit of Game 7 when the Bulls lost to the Pistons. I need you to get to a place in your life right now where you say enough is enough. I'm not going one more day like this. I'm not going one more day where I got to live like this. I'm not going one more day with this frustration. I'm not going one more day with this anger. I'm not going one more day where we're not going to fix it. I'm not going one more day being happy with average. I'm not going one more day being happy with good. I'm not going one more day ignoring you. I'm not going one more day acting like we don't got some deep-rooted issues. I'm not going one more day acting like I'm satisfied with myself. I'm not going one more day. No, I know what I want. I believe I can have what God says I can have in my health. I believe I can have what God said I can have, amen, in my fitness, my finances, my family, hallelujah, in every area I wrote down on that vision board. I believe it, and I need the Lord. Enough ain't enough for me. I say enough is enough, but it ain't real. I say it, but I go back to doing the same stuff I was doing before. I ain't added nothing. I'm looking for other people to change before I change. I'm blaming people. I'm blaming perfect strangers who don't have nothing to do with my life. And I'm blaming them now. I done got so bad, help me to have it stacked, Father. I don't want to be like Samson. I don't want to be strong in one area. I don't want to get all of this stuff in my life and then I lose it because I didn't have it stacked. I want a habit stack, Father. I want to add. I want to be happy like I see other people happy. I know it can be done because other humans are doing it. I don't want to have to rely on people in certain areas. God, but I'm not, I want a habit stack. I'm not habit stacking, Lord. I'm bragging about one area that I'm strong in, two areas, three areas I'm strong in. I want to put all my eggs in this basket over here, but I don't want to deal with, I want a habit stack, Father. I want to forgive. I don't want to keep talking about the same stuff that happened to me over 30, 40, 50 years ago, Father. I want to forgive. I want to be more competitive, Lord. I want to make better decisions, Father. Hallelujah, Lord. I want to be more enthusiastic, Lord. I don't want to put off this energy, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. I want to be consistent, Father. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, Father. I look at Mike. I need a system, Father. I need a system. And so help, Father. Help. I'm tired of going in circles, Lord. I'm tired of waking up to the same day. I'm tired of having the same problems every day or every third day or every other day. I'm tired. Every year we're going through the same stuff. I'm tired. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm tired of going to bed early, Lord, because I'm frustrated. I'm tired of waking up and not even wanting to get out of the bed. I don't even want to take a shower. I'm tired, Lord. I'm tired of feeling exhausted and frustrated. I'm tired, Lord. When is it going to be my day? And I can hear you say, I've been wanting to be your day, but you won't have it stacked. You're trying to hold on to those same gifts. You bragging about stuff you did 5, 6 years ago. Add. So, Father, help us to add in the name of Jesus. Some of us need to go back to school and get that degree. Some of us need to go to counseling. Some of us, Lord, need to hit the weight room, Lord. Some of us need to change our diets so we could be around for our babies. So we could be around for our grandbabies, Lord. Some of us, Lord, we need to make some serious adjustments and stop making excuses. Help, Jesus, help. We know we could do better. We want to do better. We know we deserve better, Father. Help. And then finally, Lord, there's a group of us, we brag because we got it going on, and we do. But there's still some areas, Lord, that we lack in. And we want to act as though because we are super strong and phenomenal in these areas, that it gives us the right to be average in these areas. We feel like, Lord, because we're so dominant in the paint that we can miss free throws, and it's okay to miss free throws. But it's not okay, Father, because the same way we became dominant in the paint, if we would use that energy on the free throw, we could get better. And so humble us, Lord. Humble us. And just as the Bulls created their own quarantine, may we use this quarantine because we don't have to do some of the things that we normally have to do. May we use it to add. Now, Satan, we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, that you will remove Satan from us. You will remove those bad habits from us, those excuses from us, and you will let us rise to another level. Lord, help us to take this message and apply this message where we know it needs to be applied. And may we be better husbands and better wives and better children and better employees and better bosses and better preachers and better teachers. May we be better, Father. And may our family and friends be better as a result of us being better. So we love you, we praise you, we worship you, we honor you, we adore you, we magnify your name because you are worthy to be praised. Now take us to another level, I pray. Not because we're worthy, but in Jesus' name, forgive us for our sins and our shortcomings. And let the believer say, amen, amen, amen. Praise God, amen. Come on, praise God wherever you are. Praise God wherever you are. With that same piece of paper, if you haven't written down the things you need to add, write those things down and make them known unto God right now. Make your request known to God right now, in the name of Jesus. Talk to Daddy right now and say, Father, I've been bragging all this time about what I'm great at, but I didn't want to acknowledge the areas, Lord. I'm embarrassed, Lord. There's no reason to be embarrassed. Lord, I felt guilty and ashamed. I didn't even want to deal with that stuff, Lord. I know I should be better by now. I know I shouldn't be putting these responsibilities on other people. I know I should be independent. I know I shouldn't be in this situation. I know I should be much further along the road, less travel. And I didn't even want to deal with this stuff because it's so embarrassing. But it's not embarrassing. Whom the Son set free is free indeed. But if we don't deal with it or address it, we're never going to overcome it. And so we don't brag anymore, Lord, about how great we are. We look at the areas that we've not surrendered and submitted to you, and we submit those areas to you today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, say, I've got the victory in Jesus' name. Come on, say it. I got the victory. Hallelujah. I got the victory in Jesus. Come on. I got the victory. Come on, say it. I got the victory. I'm going to overcome in this area. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Jamie, do you have something for us? Amen. Do you have a closing song for us? Praise God. Amen. Praise God. As hallelujah. As we close, amen, with the hymn of meditation. Hallelujah. I ask that you would begin to see yourself in that area that you have been unafraid to address. Some 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. See yourself addressing it. See yourself getting the victory. And see that area that has held you down. See yourself getting free of that and being more of a blessing to your family. Like that area. See yourself overcoming that area, growing in that area, getting to the next level in that area. Praise God. I want you to see yourself. Imagine it right now. Imagine you not having to deal with that issue no more. Imagine you being free from that issue. Imagine you being free of that bondage. Imagine. And remember what I told you, grace. Eventually, Samson hair start growing back. God will never leave you nor forsake you. And so you don't have to feel ashamed or embarrassed. You don't have to feel that way. There is grace at the altar. There is grace for God's babies, for God's children. There is grace for you. There's grace for me. Walk in that grace. Walk in that grace. Walk in the strength of God. Amen.
Against the law, no one can, and no one will. Who will stand against the King? No one can, and no one will. Oh,